are you, lady?
Mind times we are not always going to be in
must not ask for those five. I confess.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, the love of Christ compels us, once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all may die. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him, for their sake, die and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him so no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In this gospel passage that we just heard, the disciples were told, woke up Jesus, saying, "Teacher, do you not care?" In their desperation, they weren't asking a question, but they were simply crying out for help. "We are going down," basically. That's what they were saying. They cried for help. The question is, would we in any way identify with the disciples in our own lives, in our own struggles? Can we also hear ourselves crying out? Not that we're listening for anyone to give us an answer, and then simply shouting out to the Lord because of that situation that we find ourselves in. The disciples have come to know the long-awaited prophet, the man Jesus, not just like any other ordinary person, the one who called them away from their ordinary lives. And just as they left their old ways of life behind, they continued to discover that new person. Not just a new person they have met, but someone new in themselves. They continue to discover that new person in the prophet's teachings, in the prophet's miracles, and of course, in his very person. And one such discovery happened at sea, in that storm, where that discovery made them cry out, because it was just too overwhelming. It was too much for them. They couldn't all take it in at once. It was in the very presence. And the issue also reminds us of that saying, God won't give us more than we can handle. So, we tend to ask, when we're going through that situation, through that moment in life, why me, Lord? Where are you? If you can truly do this for me. Because of our own human limitations, we tend to ask all these questions. It is a cry that is often let out when we simply focus on our fears, on the self, and forget to acknowledge the presence of Him who has power over all of creation and continues to sustain His work and all things in being. He will never let us down. It is a lesson we learn in today's first reading, the story of Job and God in that exchange, making clear to us that all our fears amount to nothing. As God asked Job, "Were you there at creation? Do you know where all the controls in nature reside? Do you know where the base for all these ocean water lie? Because God, in His infinite mercy and goodness, always provides for us. And He does this without us, because of His divine power. And Jesus uses His divine power to calm the storm at sea, thereby restoring order, not just over troubled waters, but also order into our lives when we're going through those troubled times. Because He also works as His Father does. With His power, He surely will control the forces of evil in the world. And He does so today. No matter what it is that is going on out there, particularly in the world today, Jesus does control the forces of evil. So Paul reminds us of our oneness in Christ through our baptism. For us all who are baptized in the waters, we die with Christ and we rise with Him to that new life. Whatever we may be subjected to, in flesh, the salvation won for us by Christ in the Spirit through His own death and resurrection, it means that we all have become triumphant with Him as we are raised in that waters of baptism. And it is in the Spirit that we are called to be a people of hope. Always looking forward, always looking ahead, not held down, not pulled back by the evil one. To rise above the limitations of the flesh. To see with spiritual eyes, because we are a spiritual people in God. Spiritual eyes, the plan that God has for us, the plan to be the triumphant people of God. And that is the good news that our Lord has for us. And it's here that I'm now going to now present to you the message that I also bring before you this day of the missionary work of the church, to which I'm now going to also encourage you to be part of. I'm not going to do the typical fundraising pitch. I'm going to try to be obedient. I have been doing missionary work, and we all are missionary people because the church by nature is called to be a missionary people. As Jesus, as the apostles, go forth. And in going forth, we're being sent. And when we all collaborate, support, what we're doing is mission work. When I was ordained, shortly after, I was also assigned back brought to Nigeria to work, to teach. And what I experienced there was that there are so many who, without the help of others, would not be able to afford the means of good education. Education is important, as we all know, in this part of the world. And so one of the things that my community does is try to bring it to the awareness of others that this is what is going on, this is the situation, and encourage those with means to try and support the work that we do back in Nigeria. Trying to support young children, youths, who would love to be educated, but without the support of others, would simply not be able to do that. We, my community, has schools at the elementary level and also for the high school. And what we do is give the scholarship to all these individuals going up to 400. And what we do is ask for individuals to try and support. What I also did back then was I was appointed as the director of students. Students meaning those who were in formation to become priests. Now there are about 80 of them. And without the support of individuals like you all here, the community will not be able to continue supporting all these young men studying to become priests. And I will just share my own story with you. When I was also studying to become a priest at the seminary level, a family, a couple, right here in Israel, became my own sponsor. And when I got the scholarship to come over here to finish my formation, I was ordained in Baltimore and they were there. And they came over to tell me how it was the happiest day to finally see that this is the fruit of what they have been sponsoring for so many years come to fruition. That would be something anyone here could also experience. And I will just put it before you all to consider whichever one of these that God may be calling you to be part of. No one needs to force themselves in any way. Just be open to what God may be asking at any point. And may the Lord, in His goodness and mercy, continue to bless all your efforts.
Not made consubstantial. Gives our prayer and our concerns to the altar today. Let's join together in singing number 440. You are near, number 440.
Standing on
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, the Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the wickedness of his house, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the worlds and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we are praying.
Remember, Lord, your church
spread throughout the world, and bring help with fullest charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Zubin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your peace. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, the spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Great and great and mighty name, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and